Good morning, Pastor Chris, Pastor Trudy, and your congregation. The Lord bless you this morning, and He has blessed you. If you can hear my voice this morning, you are blessed. You're not deaf. You can hear. Praise God. You can walk. You can talk. You can see. You can smell. You can taste. You can touch. And there's so many people today that cannot do those things. And maybe some of you have that affliction. I don't know, but we'll pray later on that God heals you, and God is a God that heals. He says so in Isaiah 53, verse 5. I believe it with all of my heart. But you know, this morning I sent you a song there, and I love singing Psalm 13, verse 6. I will sing to the Lord because He has been good to me. God has been so good to me. The best thing He ever did was go to Calvary for me and shed His precious blood. Hebrews 9, verse 22. My praise here, Here, broer, vanmôre wil ek net sê that we thank Jesus for every situation that we're in. It's difficult. It's difficult at times that I'm sitting here thinking, Lord, how am I going to do this? How am I going to get through that? Where's the finance coming for this? We're all in the same boat, but we must make sure that the boat can float, my man. And to get it to float, sometimes it's going to take on some water, but all in the boat, just help throw some water out, get some rubbish out of your life, and just say, Lord, I'm starting over, and He will get you to where you're going to go. Philippians 1 verse 6, where it says that for the good work the Lord has started, He won't stop till He's finished. And praise God, when I think about singing, I love singing, and Romans 11 verse 29, for the gifts and the calling of God are without repentance. That's a gift. God has given you a gift. Romans 5 verse 1 to 5 speaks about it. Verse 5 says that He's left us the gift of the Holy Spirit. Man, what more do you need? Zechariah 4 verse 6. For it's not by might, it's not by power, but it's by my Spirit, says the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Here, broer. And He says to worship Him in spirit and truth. Speak in tongues. And you know something? If you can't speak in tongues, then sing, praise, do anything. But there's a scripture I love. It's 2 Chronicles 20, 22. Now when they began to sing and to praise the Lord, the Lord set ambushes against the people of Ammon and Moab and Mount Seir, who had come against Judah, and they were defeated. Listen to that. They were defeated. For the people of Ammon and Moab stood up against the inhabitants of Mount Seir to utterly kill and destroy them. And when they had made an end of the inhabitants of Seir, they helped to destroy one another. So when Judah came to a place overlooking the wilderness, they looked toward the multitude, and there, praise God, were the dead bodies fallen on the earth. No one had escaped. Isn't that incredible? Is that not fantastic? Praise the Lord. You know, I myself, Ken, I got as far as standard 7 at school. I took the gap in standard 8 and went and became a tradesman, and then went on to become a professional muser. And praise the Lord, 1 Corinthians 1:27, now the Lord will use the foolish things of the world to confound the wise. And He's confounded me. So if someone is a foolish person, and in Psalm 14 verse 1 says, call no man a fool. But you know, there was a man who was a fool in the Bible. His name was Nabal. And the man's name means fool. He came up against David. He wouldn't help David and his men after they had helped him. And he was a fool, and he died a stupid death. So I want to encourage you today in the name of Jesus. There's nothing impossible for my Lord. Nothing impossible. As that song says, I will praise the Lord. Philippians 4 verse 67 says, don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything, and you'll experience God's peace, which should keep your hearts and your minds at rest as you trust in Christ Jesus. I once had a guy that owed me a lot of money, and before that I led him to the Lord and prayed with him, and I gave him a card with that scripture on Philippians 4 verse 67. When I went to ask him for my money, he just showed me the card. And you know, that man, before he died, he found me up and he said, Ken, I want to just ask you to forgive me for all the things I did and all the things I didn't pay you for. And I loved him. He was my friend. And, you know, Jesus has paid the price for me and for you. So this morning, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, I come up against arthritis. I come up against cancer in the name of Jesus. I come up against heart problems. I come up against angina, migraine, headaches. I come up against aches and pains in your body. I come up against depression, you filthy, lying spirit. I come up against the spirit of lack. And I speak God's blessings over you this morning in the name of Jesus. Satan, I bind you by the blood of the Lamb. Revelation 12 verse 11, that we overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. Jesus, include me and my family in this prayer. Oh, Rabbasicha Masalamaka. Lord, let something happen for us and these people. It has happened on Calvary. Now, Lord, just extend it, expand it into our lives now. And Lord, that we'll just take today. Psalm 118, verse 24. For this is the day that the Lord hath made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. And Jesus said to me, he said, you know what, Ken? I said, what, Lord? You say, what do you mean? Is God talking to you? Yes, he speaks to me through signs and wonders. And he said, Ken, just take today. I said, yes, Lord. He said, how many hours? I said, 24 hours, Lord. I do know that. Thank you, Lord. And he said, how many minutes in an hour? I said, 60. He said, how many seconds in a minute? I said, 60. He said, you're living second by second, my child. And every second I'm in charge of. My friend was talking to his wife, Lawrence, and she just went, and in front of him, having a cup of tea, she just went to be with the Lord. You know, a woman said to me once, you know, I lost my husband. Well, you've lost nothing. Jesus found him. That's why it's important. 1 Timothy 5 verse 8, if you do not take care of your relatives or your immediate family, you've denied the faith and you're worse than an unbeliever. Family stands for, the Holy Spirit showed me, fathers and mothers, I love you. F-A-M-I-L-Y. It's amazing. I couldn't spell at school. I was dyslexic. Today I can read the Bible. I make a few mistakes. And then family also stands for faith and mercy. I leave you. What more do we want, guys? Jesus went to Calvary. He says, I intercede for you to the Father. No one comes to the Father except through me. John 14 verse 6. Then he still leaves us the Holy Spirit. Then he still leaves us angels. Matthew 18 verse 10. And Psalm 91. What more? What will you nog hê, broer, sister? Start praising the Lord in your kitchen, in your car, wherever you are. You want money? Give money. You want respect? Give respect. You want love? Give love. You want trouble? You'll get trouble. As Elvis Presley said, if you're looking for trouble, you come to the right place. If you're looking for Jesus, you'll find him in the Word. That's the right place. Die Here is seën julle. Thank you, Pastor Chris and Trudy, for the wonderful work you're doing. We thank you for your kindness and love. And may you be blessed even more in your church, in Jesus' name. From myself, Ken, Amore, David, and Shanae, and even our little doggies here, Ecclesiastes 9, verse 4. Better to be a live dog than a dead lion. But Jesus, we thank you today for every blessing. Amen.
Bleeding in the darkness, the cell was cold and black. Driven to unconsciousness, stripes upon his back. Heard a voice call out his name, his mind began to clear. And in the darkness, he replied, Silas, I am here. Oh, my brother Silas, Paul gave out with a groan. Today I thought for sure we were going home. I opened up my eyes, you had that look upon your face. that here we are together in this dreadful place. But I will praise the Lord. I will praise the Lord. No matter what tomorrow brings, what it has in store, I know that I'm gonna praise the Lord. Yeah, yes, I will praise the Lord. I will praise the Lord. No matter what tomorrow brings, what it has in store, I know that I will praise the Lord. This may be a prison, and we may be in chains. Still I'm free, free to praise His name. And in the tribulation, my heart begins to sing. He is the King of Kings. Prisoners started waking up as singing filled their ears. Some of them started swearing, others were in tears. Oh, suddenly it happened, and there was no mistake, as Paul and Silas began to praise the Lord. I'm gonna praise the Lord.